The first Corvette was built in 1953. The outer body was built out of fiberglass, partly because of lingering steel shortages from the war. After slow sales, Chevy almost canceled the Corvette before taking a chance instead with a radical redesign. The engine was upgraded to a small block V8, turning the Corvette into America's first true sports car. Through the years, the improvements paid dividends, as the Corvette went on to become a force to be reckoned with on the racetrack. The Corvette has won at Daytona, captured numerous Trans Am victories, and won its class at the 24 Hours of Le Mans 7 times in a row. Even with all the victories, the Corvette is still in reach of the typical car buyer. The Corvette is one of the best performance-to-dollar purchases in the world. Thank you. This is your 1967 Brabham BT24. When the driver of the first mid-engine car to win a Formula One championship decided to make his own racing company, he named it Motor Racing Developments Limited, but everyone called it by the founder's name, Brabham. Starting in 1961, Sir Jack Brabham's company rose to fame as one of the most prolific manufacturers in all of open-wheel racing. They were the first team to use wind tunnels to shape their cars for high-speed stability, and first to develop carbon brakes, a staple of modern race cars. The BT46B even used a fan to add downforce, a technology outlawed after winning its inaugural race. Brabham race cars were driven to victory not only by legends such as Niki Lauda, Dan Gurney, and Nelson Piquet, but also by Jack Brabham himself. With two world championships already under his belt, in 1966, Sir Jack Brabham became the only driver in history to win a Formula One championship in a car of his own creation.
Thank you.
This is your 1939 Audi Auto Union Type D. Auto Union was formed in 1932 by the merger of automotive powerhouses DKW, Porsche, Wanderer, and Audi. Their unity was represented by a logo of four rings, an iconic symbol used in today's models. To demonstrate their technical prowess, Auto Union entered Grand Prix racing soon after their merger. These first GP cars became known as the Silver Arrows and were direct rivals to cars from Mercedes-Benz. Grand Prix rules placed limitations on weight, but not on engine size, and the resulting supercharged V16 and V12 engines created tremendous power. Auto Union's mid-engine designs improved aerodynamics and lowered the center of gravity, but required the most skilled drivers. With low-drag bodywork and other preparations, Auto Union set over 36 speed records across various classes. Thank you. Henry Ford was more than a car innovator. He changed the landscape of America forever. Working as an engineer for Thomas Edison in the 1890s, Henry Ford admired the genius of Edison and his keen eye for business. These traits inspired Ford to make his mark in a new industry, automobile manufacturing. When Ford founded his own company, he pioneered the assembly line production of automobiles, a dramatic shift that made cars affordable for the average person. In 1964, the Ford Company was still setting trends and shaping the industry with the unprecedented success of the Mustang, which helped kick off the era of small but powerful pony cars. Ford was a pioneer in international expansion as well. Ford models have dominated the European market for years, offering distinctly different vehicles than those available in North America, helping the Ford Empire remain one of the largest automakers in the world.
Thank you. Thank you.